Lay it all down again to sing, let's say that I'm your friend. You are my desire. Bring us back to you. You're all I want. You're all I ever needed. You're all I want. Draw us close. Sir, to you, hallelujah, praise the Lord. I've been in a worship theme right now, or phase right now, because I've been watching collegiate worship of the Asbury University, Collegiate Day of Prayer from the Asbury Revival from last night. I'm watching a live recording, so I've been doing a lot of singing, praise the Lord, hallelujah, and praising God and prayer, hallelujah. Lord, we pray for that Asbury Revival to continue to ignite college campus throughout this nation and world, and families and schools, high schools. We pray, Father God, people's hearts will turn back to you and come to you. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, the theme today is bullying, because at work we did the National Day of Bullying, and I'll be sharing the notes below the link. And I just wanted to just continue the theme. Lord, we pray that the people that bully, the bullies, forgive them, Father God, for they do not know what they do. We pray for those who've been bullied. We pray, Father God, their dependence and trust in you will grow. May they come to you as their Lord and Savior, and that they'll know that you will protect them and that you are with them, that they're not alone. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All right, I found a Bible verse on the theme of bullying. And I'll read from, there's a lot of verses that I wanted to read, but I already done videos of it already. So like Matthew 5 and especially Romans 12, about feeding your enemy. Like if someone bullies you and calls you names, just get back to them and say, God loves you, or you're awesome, you're beautiful. Then they'll be totally thrown off, maybe. And they go, that's another way to get back at those who bully you. Feed the those who persecute you. Tomorrow, no, I don't work. All right, I'll read from Romans 15. It's one of many Bible verses on the theme of bullying. And Lord, we pray, Father God, that you bless this word. We pray those who hear this word, may you personally speak to them wherever they're at with you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, I'll read the Bible now. Romans chapter 15 in the book of epistles in the New Testament. All right, I'll read the Bible now. Romans chapter 15. Now we who are strong ought to bear the weakness of the powerless and not just please ourselves. Let each of us please his neighbor for his good, for building him up. For even Messiah did not please himself, but as it is written, the insults of those who insulted you have fallen on me. For whatever was written before was written for our instructions, so that through patience and the encouragement of the strict scriptures we might have hope. Now may the God of patience and encouragement grant you to be like-minded with one another in the manner of Messiah Yeshua, so that together with one voice you may glorify the God and Father of our Lord Yeshua the Messiah. The next chapter theme is salvation for Gentiles too. Verse 7, therefore accept one another just as Messiah also accepted you to the glory of God. For I declare that Messiah has become a servant to the circumcised for the sake of God's truth, in order to confirm the promises given to the patriarchs and for the Gentiles to glorify God for his mercy, as it is written. For this reason I will give you praise among the Gentiles, and I will sing to your name. And again it says, rejoice, O Gentiles, with his people. And again, praise Adonai, all you Gentiles, and let all the people praise him. And again, Isaiah says, there shall be a short shoot of Jesse, and the one who arises to rule the Gentiles, in him shall the Gentiles hope. Now may the God of hope fill you with all joy and shalom in trusting, so you may overflow with hope in the power of the Rosh HaKodesh. Now I myself am convinced about you, my brothers and sisters, that you may also are full of goodness, filled with all knowledge, and all able to counsel one another. But I have written rather boldly to you on some points as a reminder, because of the grace given to me by God to be a servant of Messiah Yeshua to the Gentiles in priestly service to the good news of God, so that the offering up of the Gentiles might be pleasing, made holy by the Rosh HaKodesh. So in Messiah Yeshua I have reason to boast before God, for I will not dare to speak of anything except the Messiah accomplished through you, through me, to bring about the obedience of the Gentiles by word and deed, in the power of signs and wonders, in the power of the Spirit of God. So from Jerusalem and around even to Lycrium, I have fully proclaimed the good news of Messiah. In this way I make it in my aim to proclaim good news, not where Messiah was already named, lest I build on another person's foundation, but as it is written, those who have never been told shall see, and those who have not heard shall understand. The next chapter theme is going to the ends of the earth. And verse 22, the last theme. For this reason I was often hindered from coming to you, but now with no place in these regions, and since I have had a desire for many years to come to you, I hope to see you while traveling through when I go to Spain, and to be helped on my journey there by you. At first I may enjoy our company for a bit, but now I am going to Jerusalem, bringing aid to the Kiddushim. For Macedonia and Achaia were pleased to make some contribution for the poor among the believers in Jerusalem. Yes, they were pleased to do so, and they are under obligation to them. For if the Gentiles have shared in their spiritual blessings, they also ought to serve them in material blessings. So when I have finished delivering the collection safely to them, I will head for Spain by way of you. Now I know that when I come to you, I will come in the fullness of the blessing of Messiah. Now I urge you, brethren, through our Lord Yeshua the Messiah, and through the love of Rosh, to press on together with me with prayers to God on my behalf. Pray that I might be rescued from the unbelieving Judeans, and that my service for Jerusalem might be acceptable to the Kedoshim. Then, God willing, I may come to you in joy, and together with you find rest. Now may the God of Shalom be with you all. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God be with you all. May the peace be with you all as you hear this word. And may God use you to help spread the word. And that's one of many Bible verses on bullying. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, we pray, Father God, not the only bullying going on in school, but bullying going on in homes, the domestic, spiritual, physical abuse, or any type of abuse in homes, schools too, and workplace and anywhere, or even the political government or institution or anywhere. We pray that people will stop bullying or abusing others. We pray, Father God, those who are been victims, we pray, Father God, for the armor of God, and that they'll feel your love to show that love to those who persecute them or bully them, and that those who persecute and bully will turn their hearts to you. Soften their hearts, Lord, in Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah, praise the Lord, hallelujah. And this is some video noise from the Asbury Revival prayer that I'm watching right now. It's a tape recording, but you can watch the rest of it. I'll share the link below. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Right now, the temperature is 1 degree right now. It's 10 degrees over there, and wow. We had minus 17 in, we had minus 17 here. Hopefully you can hear this. That's the loudest it gets, really. Anyways, a pastor is talking about being commissioned to share the good news. Three above, wow. Tomorrow the high will be 22. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord, hallelujah.